Dear students, my name is Jitesh Kumar. I am starting math classes for 12th and GE main for 2022-2021. So today I start one topic of algebra, which is determinant. First of all, determinant. What is determinant? It gives always a unique number either real or complex. So determinant always gives a unique number, either it is real or complex. Now, how determinant can be written? Order of 2, 3, and 4. The determinant, of order 2, 3, and 4 can be written like that. As soon. First of all, we write 2 by 2 determinant. Like A1, B1, A2, B2. Okay. This is 2 by 2 determinant. Next, 3 by 3 determinant, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. This is 3 by 3 determinant. Now I can write 4 by 4 determinant, A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C3, D3, A4, B4, C4, D4. It is 4 by 4 determinant. So, 4 by 4 determinant is like A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C3, D3, A4, B4, C4, D4. Like that, this is 4 by 4 determinant. Respectively, we can write. Respectively, okay? Now we generalize. In general, a determinant of order n is written like that. You can see here we can write A1n, A11, A12, A13. We can write respectively and go up to A1n. Okay, next we can write here A21, A22, A23, and go on A2n. Okay, and so on. In bottom we can also go like that. Okay, and we can write here an1, an2, an3, and so on. We can go like that, ann. Okay, this is general form of n by n determinant. Okay, here this is C1. Only we can see here, you do not understand what I am talking, but after some time, after a few time you can understand well. C3, this is CN, okay. This is R1, this is R2, and so on we go. This is RN, okay. Now you can understand here what is R1, R2, RN, C1, C2, C3, CN. Okay. First off, this is N by N determinant in general form. Okay. So some remarks you have remember it and see. Here, first I write here the horizontal lines counting from top to bottom are called rows and denoted by R1, R2, RN, like that. Okay. You can also take other notation, but in general in book take R1, R2, RN. Okay. So what I am saying, the horizontal lines counting from top to bottom. Okay. This is horizontal. You can see here, this is horizontal line, this horizontal, this first horizontal line, this is first row, this is second horizontal line, this is second row, and so on, go on, top, bottom, and this is RN, this is N number of rows, nth number of rows, okay? So it is, here write is RN, okay? Now, this is first, okay. Now remark second, column, okay. So the vertical line counting from left to right are called columns and are denoted by how much? C1, C2, C3, and so on. So you understand what is row and what is column. Rows, the horizontal lines counting from top to bottom are called rows, and the vertical lines counting from left to right are called columns and are denoted by letter you can so on. Now remarks third, the elements of a determinant are denoted by AIJ. First off, you understand what I am saying. This is basic. So you have to remember it and understand what I am saying. After that, you can go smoothly. No problem. But as in a starting, some problem happen without this type of basic things known. So this is what the limits of a determinant are denoted by AIJ, where I denotes what? Row, number, and J denotes column number. Okay, this is column number. Now we consider one determinant, then all of us understand clearly. Now consider a determinant, okay, short form determinant. like that. Suppose this is 2, minus 3, 4, 0, minus 1, minus 3, 4, 7, 2. Okay? You understand? You see in previous sometime, this is 3 by 3 determinant. Okay? So this is vertical line, this is column, and this is horizontal line, this is row. So in this first row, second row, third row, first column, second column, third column. Okay? Now, if we want to find any element of this determinant, suppose that we want to find A12, element of this is first row. First letter denotes row number, and second letter denotes column number. Okay, this notation of element is first row and second column. In first row and second column, you can see which element. From here, first row, this is first row. Second column, this is second column. So first row and second column, this is minus 3. Okay, now you can also write second column, second row. A22 means second row in second column. You can see second row, this is second column, here is minus 1. Now go on, so on go. A32 like that, you can see third row and second column, third row, second column, this is 7. So this is the element of a determinant, element A12 minus 3, A22 minus 1, and element A32 is 7. Now you can write element 33. You can see third row, third column. This is 2. Now for 3 marks, an element A11 is called leading element. Okay, first element is called leading element. First element in first row and first column, first element is called leading element. Next remarks 5, you can understand it very carefully. An element Aij, in means first element ith row and jth column, is called diagonal element if I row number equals to column number. In above determinant, you can see in which condition row number equals to column number. In first, you can write here A11, it is row 1 and column is also 1. So A11 is equals to 2. Now you can write A22, this is second row in second column, which number is minus 1. And A33, which number? A33 means third row and third column, this is 2. But if we want to choose one element, which is A21, what is A21? If we take A21, means second row, first column, this is not the valid condition for diagonal element, because for diagonal element, row number equals to column number. If row number is not column number, then this is not a diagonal element. A21 is equals to what? Second row, first column, this is 0, but it is not a diagonal number. Diagonal element. Okay.